is not possible to complete all the principles, philosophy, and packages of the practices within 2 days. Not even this workshop is organized for giving the technology. All the club technologies are given in my books, and you can get. But this today, we are going to discuss how to change our lifestyle towards the nature. What will be the remedies or solutions to solve the problems, those problems which will destroy the future of the next generation? Because we are having the commitments in our close hand at the birth time given by the God. And it is our duty to follow these commitments and fulfill the desire of the God.
Local earthworms and microorganisms, these are the two wheels of this ratha, fertility of the soil. And because of the activation of the local earthworms, soil become totally porous, and when there is rainfall, entire rainfall is percolated in the soil through these holes, and entire rainfall is deposited in the internal water reservoir in the deeper soil zone. No single drop of the rainwater will flow upon the soil where there are activities of the local earth. And after completion of the rainy season, this internal water reservoir water will come up by means of the capillary force, and when they will come up, the nitrate, phosphate, potash and micronutrients are dissolved in the incoming upgoing water, and when the water will come up by means of the capillary force, only water vapor will go in the atmosphere by means of the trans-evaporation process, and entire nutrients will be deposited near the root zone, and ocean of the nutrients are available to the plant body. So there is a great role has been given by the God to the local earthworms. Number one, to give available the ocean of the nutrient to the roots of the plants through their casting. Number two, to conserve entire rainwater in the soil. And number three, to erect the soil so that the microorganisms and the roots can get the oxygen through the circulating air in through the holes and in the network of the holes. So I think that local earthworms and microorganisms, these are the two wheels of this ratha, fertility of the soil. Microorganisms are responsible for the creation of the humus. And you are well known now, humus is the fertility of the soil. That means there is a great role to the microorganism has been given by the God. And second one, by means of the local earthworm activities, the watershed management program, that is natural watershed management program without any single rupee funds from funding agency and government, entire rainwater is deposited, and that water will be available to the roots naturally by means of the capillary movement process. That means these two are most important. And we have destroyed the microorganisms and local earthworms. That means we have to introduce again in the soil these main creator of the fertility in the soil, but it is zero budget. We are not going to purchase anything from the market. Money from villages will not go to the cities, but money from cities will come to the villages. So it is our duty, nothing to be purchased from the market. That means culture of the microorganism and culture of the local earthworms will not be purchased from the market. Then, which is the media by which we can introduce these local earthworms and microorganisms in the soil? Otherwise, what the matter we have to utilize by which these microorganisms and local earthworms will be attracted naturally? And then I started to search out what will be the medium, and after research I found there is a great attraction of the local cow dung to these microorganisms and local earthworms. I will give an example. While grazing, when the cows are returning back to the villages evening, they drop their dungs on the bank of the path. Next morning you go and you lift one fallen dung of the Deshi cow. And below that dung, you will see there are 2-3 holes to the soil. I have dug the soil up to 15 feet and taken 2000 samples of variable soil types. And I was searching out which worms are come up through the holes. At last I found the two worms are coming up. Number one worm which prepare the ball size of the dung and push forward, and second one local earthworms. That means if you want to attract the local earthworms which are dormant, which are in the samadhi stage in the deeper soil, we have to attract them, and for that purpose Deshi cow dung is the best media to attract the microorganism, because cow dung is the ocean of the microorganism, and to attract the local earthworm. That means we have prepared Jivamrutam, Ghana Jivamrutam, and when we add Jivamrutam, you will see miracle. In chemical farming, you dig the soil, you will not get single local earthworm. But you take one trial, you add Jivamrutam on the soil, and after third day, you see small local earthworms are coming up. After 15 days, the total soil will be saturated by the local earthworms. The local earthworms, which was dormant in samadhi stage, they break the samadhi, they break the dormancy, and come up to the Jivamrutam speedily, and they are activated. That means, if you want to activate the local earthworms and microorganisms for the creation of the fertility of the soil and availability of the nutrient to the root zone, it is very essential to utilize Jivamrutam and Ghanajivamrutam. Understood? Yeah. But these local earthworms are not activated if they are not getting the proper microclimate, proper situation. And that microclimate is very essential for the activation of the local earthworms. And that microclimate, that means 25 to 32 degrees centigrade temperature of the atmosphere near the soil, and 65 to 72% of the relative humidity, and there should be darkness and vapsa, and then the local earthworms are activated speedily. That means microclimate is very essential for the activation of the local earthworms. And only when you utilize the straw mulching on the surface of the soil in between two lines of the crop, automatically the microclimate is created and local earthworms are activated and microorganisms are activated. That means if you will utilize only Bijambutam, it is not enough. If you will utilize only Jivambutam, it is not enough. If we will not utilize the straw mulching, otherwise you will not create the resistance power, microclimate in the soil, local earthworms will not be activated. Humus will not be created. For that purpose, we have to link these trees, Bijambutam, Jivambutam and mulching, and then the local earthworms and microorganisms will be activated. That means the three are most important. But if there is no oxygen inside the soil, the three are become useless. That means again the fourth part of this practice, that is a vapsa. Vapsa is most essential. If there is no vapsa, none of the local earthworms can activate and microorganisms can activate. And even if there is no vapsa, the roots are not getting the oxygen for their survival, and then the immunity of the plant body is reduced. Ultimately, so many diseases are affected, attacked, and insects are attacking the crop, and you will not get the benefit. So, Bijambutam is essential. Simultaneously, Jivambutam application is essential. Mulching is essential. And even vapsa also is essential. Vapsa, write down vapsa. What is vapsa? What is vapsa? Vapsa is a ultimate new term for agriculture science and farmers also. Because what you have learned today, there is no existence in the syllabuses of the agriculture university. Write down vapsa. Agriculture universities are claiming false, telling lie. That what is required for the roots? Agriculture universities are telling lie or claiming false that the roots want water. वो झूठ कह रहे हैं, गलत कह रहे हैं कृषि वैज्ञानिक कि जड़ों को पानी चाहिए. आपको उन्होंने मूर्ख बनाया. Basically, the roots do not want the water, they want vapsa for their survival. Basically, the roots do not want the water, they don't touch the water, they want vapsa. Write down, vapsa means inside the soil, vapsa means inside the soil, in between two soil particles, inside the soil, in between two soil particles, there are vacant spaces, pore spaces. There are vacant spaces in between two soil particles, there are vacant. Vacant means खाली जगह है, खाली जगह है. Post spaces, vacuoles, individual particles, there are vacant spaces in those vacant spaces There should be no any existence of the water. वहां पानी की उपस्थिति कतई नहीं चाहिए. There should be no existence of the water in these poor spaces. But there should be the mixture of fifty percent water vapor. वाटर वेपर, वेपर को क्या कहते हैं? हाँ, वाटर वेपर एंड 50% वाटर एयर, 50% वाटर वेपर मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड 50% एयर मॉलिक्यूल्स. Mixture of 50% water vapor molecules and 50% air molecules, and this situation is called vapsa. Understood? Yeah. Inside the soil, in between two soil particles, jado ke pass near the root zone. नियर द रूट जोन, कहां? जहां जड़े हैं वहां. राइट डाउन द रूट्स. The roots which are taking the vapsa and food, that means nutrients, are existed on the boundary of the moon shadow. Noon, 12 a.m. 12 a.m. 12 p.m. kya baat hai? 12 noon, okay? किसी भी पौधों की खाद्य तत्व और वापसा लेने वाली जड़े उस पौधों की दोपहर को 12 बजे जो छाया पड़ती है उस छाया के सीमा पर होती है. कहाँ होती है? सीमा पर, ऑन द बाउंड्री ऑफ द शैडो. दैट मीन्स द रूट्स आर नॉट इन्वेस्टेड inside the roots are existed on the boundary of the soil. That means The water should not be given inside the shadow. That means the water should not be given inside the shadow. At any cost. At any cost. Even rainwater also should not be dumped inside the shadow in rainy season. Even the rainwater also should not be dumped inside the shadow in rainy season. Otherwise, roots are spoiled. Vapsa is not maintained. कहाँ पानी देना है फिर? अंदर नहीं देना है ना? Where to raise the soil from the boundary up to stem? Where to raise the soil from the boundary up to soil so that rainwater will be immediately go outside the canopy. हमें मिट्टी को तना तक चढ़ाना है छाया से लेकर ताकि गिरने वाला बारिश का पानी तुरंत बाहर निकल जाए और वापस आ रहे. सुनी में आएगा? Write down. If we are giving the water on the boundary, if we are giving the water on the boundary, how much water is required is decided by you, not by roots. If you will give the water on the boundary of the shadow, how much vapsa is required, that is decided by you, not by the roots. This is the right of the root to decide, not the right of you. That means vapsa will not maintain again. If you will give the water on the shadow boundary, vapsa will not maintain because you have poured the water in the mouth of the root. Without taking any permission of the root. But when you give the water 6 inch outside the boundary, but when you will give the water 6 inch outside the boundary, automatically vapsa will be maintained. Automatically vapsa will be maintained. कहाँ पानी देना है फिर? सीमा के कितने इंच बाहर? Change bar. That is correct. You know Hindi. Why you are doing the drama? You know Hema Malini, you know Amitabh Bachchan, you know Salman Khan, Dhurra Khan. And you are doing the drama here. Okay, my Marathi is going up. It is better. Samajh laga? Vapsa kasa nirman hoto? Samajh laga? Kya baat hai? Kya baat?